So as we continue with the pen tool, the next series in your downloads is the Trace Multi Logo. Now this exercise is just a series of different logos that's meant to help you guys continue to learn how to trace and use different shapes with fills. So practice these if you need to. I'm not going to walk you through these. You don't have to do all of them by any means. Pick one or two that look fun and practice filling those shapes, tracing them out, refining them with the direct selection tool. Because what we're going to do now is move on to using the pen tool to make isolations. Now the pen tool is a absolutely remarkable selection tool. I use it almost 98% of the time when making isolations. Why? Because we can fully adjust and manipulate the curves and lines that are going to be our selections. Whereas before we were kind of limited with the different polygonal lasso tools and the different magnetic lasso tools that would get curves but not perfectly, now we have the ability to get razor sharp, perfect isolations every time. So let's go in and practice with our cutout vase image. Now the first thing that's important to note as we get started with using the pen tool to make isolations is that we are no longer working with shapes. So up here in the option bar, we want to change the shape pull down to path. And again, this path is what the tool defaults to when you first select the pen tool. Remember, I told you that we wouldn't be working with paths because we wanted to learn how to draw using the pen tool first. And paths and shapes will function completely different. So let's go ahead and select paths. Now notice that the shape options, the fill and the stroke, are gone. It's because we're no longer drawing with the pen tool. Now, when I start to click and drag, you'll notice that this looks very similar. In fact, the interface of the pen tool is the same. We're still gonna click, we're still gonna click and drag and create our curves and handles, but there's no stroke, there's no fill. And notice over in our layer panel that there's no new shape that's been drawn, just layer zero. Now, as we start to work, let me control Z here, as we start to work with paths, the same principles apply as before. Our goal is to trace out this vase as clearly as possible and then go back with our white direct selection tool to refine that path. But paths are kind of like masks where by themselves, they don't do anything. They're layer independent. You could apply and draw as many paths as you wanted to and they don't change the image. Like masks, paths are meant to have things applied to them, and that's where the magic comes into play. And so think of paths as kind of like drawing different railroads for different trains to run down. We get to decide what those trains are, and one of them can be isolations. So as we start to draw paths, don't think of it in terms of drawing a shape. We're drawing out a track that we can make things follow. So to start, I like to start my vase at the very top middle. There's no curves here. We can just click and start that. Now I'm going to get through this rather, I'm going to try to speed this up and get through it quickly, but take some time and trace out the vase as accurately as possible, knowing that we can go back after the fact and still change the way that the lines work with the direct selection tool. Okay, so now that we're back, we can use our direct selection arrow to come through here and refine all of the lines that were less than stellar. Take some time, use the white direct selection arrow, and come through and just start to fix the different curves. Okay, so once you have all of your points refined, and again, this is a critical step because our selection is only going to be as precise as our path is currently. So make sure you take the time necessary to refine this path edge. Now you'll notice that this path is not inherently a selection. There's no dancing dotted lines that go around this because again, paths are like railroads. We have to communicate what is going to follow this path. Now in this case, a selection is going to follow this path. And to do this, it's rather easy. But we have to first learn a new tab in our layers panel. Now notice how there is a paths tab in our layer panel. Go ahead and select that now. Now, if you completed the entire path of your vase, meaning you selected and went back to your very first point after you traced this, you should see a complete vase cutout called work path. Now, think of the paths tab as kind of like ghost vision. Paths are layer independent. I could turn off my base layer and my path still exists. I can't even take my move tool and come in here and move my path because paths don't technically exist. But we can see them when we actually go to our paths tab. So think of the paths tab as kind of like your ghost vision. You can see what isn't visible in our layer panel. So this work path is our railroad. We get to decide now what travels along it. If you right click your work path, you should see an option that says make selection. It's as easy as this. Now there's a feather radius option here. We don't want a feathered radius. A feather is like a soft edge. We want a razor sharp line. So we want this to be 0 pixels. And then simply hit okay. When you hit OK, we now see, instead of the path, we see the dancing dotted line around the vase. We've now made a selection using paths. If we go back to our layer panel, and we select our vase layer, we can simply just hit our mask icon down here at the bottom of the layer panel, and we now have a beautiful, perfect, razor-sharp selection. Now the goal here is to use the pen tool's abilities to do perfect curves and the manipulatability, if that's even a word, of the direct selection tool to come back and refine that to get those perfect selections. Again, like I said in the beginning, I love using the pen tool for isolations. It's so much more forgiving than any of the lasso tools or previous isolation methods that we've covered before. But again, the important part here is to use paths, not shapes. We're not drawing anymore. We're creating paths. Now the next image here is the cutout Ferrari. And I purposely chose kind of a low resolution image of a Ferrari so you guys wouldn't be tempted to use one of the previous pixel-based selection methods that we learned earlier. Now Ferraris are great because there's nothing but a whole bunch of curves to this car. The Italians know how to do lines. So what I want you guys to do is use the pen tool using paths to trace out the edges of this Ferrari. And again, get through it as well as possible and then go back with your direct selection tool and refine those points. Now I'm not gonna do this with you. I want this to kind of be your test of strength, see how far you can get. Watch the vase example over again if you guys need to help, you know, get through it. But I want you guys to isolate this Ferrari using paths, the pen tool, and masks.